This video we are going to discuss about three important rules for writing your content. Okay, so first one is use high school level writing pattern. Consider it an honor to publish your work, and always start your sentence with the most important words. Okay, so these are the three important rules you should follow. So we'll see one by one. So first we'll see how to write high school level writing pattern. Okay, generally comprises of five paragraph essay rules. So as the name suggests, it consists of five paragraphs. One is the introduction and another one is the conclusion. So in between introduction and conclusion, we have three different paragraphs. So first one is the first argument, second one is the second argument, and third one is the third argument. Okay, this is paragraph 1, 2, and 3. So first we'll see one by one. First introduction. So introduction always sets the structure for the rest of your content. So it always grabs the attention of the readers. Okay. So now here you are taking your supporting arguments and briefly introducing them to the reader without revealing too much information. So you should not dump all the information into the introduction part. So while writing introduction, you have to keep in mind that you have to grab the attention of the readers. Say for example, if you see the trailer of a movie, okay, in that trailer we will get glimpses of about that movie, but not the entire story about the particular film. Okay, in that way we have to give just a outline of what we are going to talk about, and we have to hook the reader, that is grab the attention of the readers. So how to write the introduction? So always write 2 to 3 sentences and start out very impressively and think about hooking up your readers. Okay, so hook sentences are always used to grab the attention of the readers. So these are some of the examples of hook sentences. You can ask some rhetorical questions. You can start with questions, literary quotes, jokes, anecdote, metaphor, simile, famous person's saying, fact, or statistics. So you can start with any of these hook sentences. Okay, so in introduction we should have three main sentences. One is a hook sentence. Hook sentences are used for grabbing the attention of the readers. Second one is a transition sentence. So this sentence is used to connect your hook statement to your main point. And third one is a thesis or main point. So here you have to summarize your claim and evidence. You should outline the topic. Okay. So now we'll take an example of preservation of our environment. Okay. So here, how can we write the hook statement? This is one example. Here I am starting with a question. Okay, do we want to live in a world that is surrounded by wasteland and desert? So if we are not preserving our environment, the earth will become a desert and wasteland. Okay, so we can start with a question like this. Do we want to live in a world that is surrounded by wasteland and desert? Okay, this will grab the attention of the reader. So they will think that why the author is asking such question. Okay, so next comes the transition statement. So here you have to create a logical relationship between this hook sentence and your main point. Okay, so example, many places of the world continue to have dangerously high levels of air pollution. As a result, 9 out of 10 people breathe air that is highly polluted. So here what we are going to say, air pollution is rising and so the people find it very difficult to breathe. Okay, so now there are some examples for transition words. Okay, so if you want to add a sentence, you can use as well as, and, to, furthermore, also, in addition to, not only but also, are, apart from this. Okay, and you have to write about causes and effect. Okay, here I have written the causes and effect. Okay, here what are the causes, effect. Okay, effect of the degradation in the environment is pollution. Okay, so due to this pollution, what are all the causes? Here 9 out of 10 people find it difficult to breathe. Okay, so I have used as a result. So in a similar way, we can use therefore, so, because, thus, hence, due to, as a result, consequently. Okay, and then emphasis. If you want to emphasize any of the sentences, that is, if you want to stress, give more stress to that particular point. In that case, you can use undoubtedly, definitely, obviously, particularly, absolutely, especially, without a doubt, clearly, and importantly. Okay. So, and if you want to compare anything, so in that case, you can use equally, similarly, likewise, same as, similar to, just as, just like, comparable, in like manner, etc. Okay, these are some of the examples of the transition words which you can use in your content. Okay, and third one is the thesis. This is a main point. Okay, the most crucial part, crucial means important part of keeping Mother Nature is balanced and preventing catastrophic disorders is the preservation of our planet. So, preservation means we have to keep our Mother Nature in balance and avoid and prevent catastrophic disasters. Okay, so we are indirectly telling that it is the responsibility of the human being, okay, to preserve our planet. So now goes the body paragraphs up. So in body paragraphs, we have three different paragraphs, 1, 2, and 3. So for all the body paragraphs, the rule will be the same. Okay, so now the first argument here, the first argument should be the strongest argument and it should be the most compelling one. That is, here if we have taken the air pollution, we have to discuss what is the major reason or what is the main cause for that air pollution. Okay, that is the first argument. Okay, so next, second one should be the second strongest. What are all the other causes for the air pollution? In that way, you have to think about writing your second paragraph. And third one is the weakest or persuasive argument, some precautions or some other factors, very least important factors which we want to highlight here. Okay, so these this is about the body paragraph. Then we'll see how we can write. Okay, so in general, the body paragraph comprises of 5 to 7 sentences. You have to write about 5 to 7 sentences. So it should include a topic sentence. Okay, so example, forest destruction and pollution not only harm the environment, but they also degrade air quality and raise health risk. So, here in body paragraph, this is the first paragraph. Okay, let us assume this is the first argument. So, here we are insisting on the health risk. Okay, so the main reason, the main cause of the environmental degradation is health risk. Okay, it creates poor air quality and also leads to health risk. Okay, so how do you say that it is risky for the people? Okay, in that way you have to write the second sentence. Second sentence is what? You have to support the argument with your explanation and you have to provide some evidence or a proof. So if you have experienced anything, you can share your experience, or if you have some real-time data or statistics, you can support your argument with those proof here. Okay, so here, selfishness and greed are the two most damaging forces to our environment. So already we have told that human beings' health is at risk. Okay, so environment is degrading. So this damage is mainly caused due to the people only. Okay, due to their selfishness and greed. So they lead to ways that harm trees and contaminate the air we breathe. So if the trees are cut down, the air will be contaminated. So while it may be advantageous in short term for a few select few, it is risky for all in the long run. Okay, so even though the people get benefited by cutting the trees, so that is only for a short term, but in a long run it is risky for themselves also. Okay, human beings are greatly affected by this deforestation. So the air quality, this is a proof. So nowadays the air quality in Delhi is very poor. So for example, is so bad that wearing mask is often required just to stroll around the city. So coming out is highly dangerous. So people are breathing in the polluted air. Okay, so this way you can support your argument with the real life examples. So now third goes the concluding statement. So in a body paragraph, you have to write a topic sentence. Next one, supporting argument and explanation. And third, you have to conclude that particular paragraph. So concluding statement means you have to summarize every point. To summarize, depletion of natural resources and poor quality harm not only the planet's but also the humanity's health. So here what we are trying to say is it not only affects the environment, it also affects the human's health. Okay, so first this is the effect of degradation in the environment. So this is the strongest argument. Okay, so this way you have to write all the other body paragraphs. Okay, so you have to write topic sentence, then supporting argument and explanation, and finally concluding sentence. Okay, so now the third is conclusion. Okay, so this is the last one in the five paragraph essay, conclusion. So conclusion has three steps. So in step one you have to restate the thesis so that the reader will remind the main point. Okay, and then it provides a summary of the essay. Okay, so now it is an example. So the Earth's safety and survival are vitally dependent on how we use as humans treat it. Okay, the more carefully we handle the process, the better it will be for everyone. So already we have discussed that human are main cause for environmental death. We have to be responsible. Okay, so then step two, you raise the main points give each body paragraph. So we have written three body paragraphs, right? So we have to summarize all the points given in the body paragraphs. So all the key ideas should be outlined, and then it will help the reader to understand the key ideas without looking back into the body paragraphs. Okay, if you give out the summary of all the main points, then they do not go back to refer your body paragraphs. It will be easy for them to remember. Okay, so don't include any new ideas here. Okay, so remember, in conclusion you should not include any new ideas. You have to summarize the points which you have already discussed. Okay, so if a few of the supporting information is similar, okay, you have written three body paragraphs, if few statements are similar in all the three paragraphs, then you can consolidate them into a single statement to maintain a logical flow. Okay, so now the example is reducing our consumption of natural resources and increasing their efficiency are critical steps towards enhancing our planet's health. To enhance or protect our planet, we have to consume, reduce the consumption of the natural resources and increase its efficiency. Okay, so now the third step, this is the most important step. You should include call to action in your conclusion. So call to action is generally written in order to make the reader think that they need to take some action. So after reading your content, they should take some action. Say for example, if you are writing a content about mobile phones under 5000 rupees. Okay, you have given a comparison of all the mobiles with pros and cons, everything. So after reading your article, the reader should take decision on purchasing the mobile. Okay, so this is one sort of call to action. So in this case, we have written preservation of our environment. So it should be it should create an awareness among your readers. Okay, they should take the responsibility to preserve our planet. Okay, in that way you have to include some call to action. So here you have to avoid using sentences like I think or I believe. Okay, so whatever the point you want to discuss, you have to be confident enough. Okay, you should prove them with your data and statistics. You have to make some research and support them with your data, real-time data. So example, so this is one example. The health of our planet is of great importance, and after all we don't want to live in a wasteland, do we? Okay, so this is just an example. So next we'll see the second rule. The second rule is consider it an honor to publish your work. So this means you have to think about your audience. Okay, always value your audience and always put forth their needs first. Please your audience with every piece of your content. So make it a priority to deliver what the audience needs. Okay, so you have to make a research on what people are asking about. So you can do it by using online tools like Google Auto Suggest or answerthepublic.com, and many other tools are available. So you have to check what are the needs of the audience. Okay, so on whatever topic you are going to write, you have to search about the audience needs. You have to identify their pain points and you have to provide them with the useful information. At the same time, it should be of interesting nature and it should inspire the audience. So these three are very, very important for writing a high quality content. So your content should be useful, interesting, and at the same time, it should inspire the audience. So next is, don't restrict the length of your content. Take as long as you need to deliver the story. Make it simple so that the audience can understand it easily. So always you write it in a simple language. So because the readers may be of different literacy levels, so they will understand it easily if you are writing in a simple language. Always develop empathy for your readers. So empathy means you have to feel along with your audience. You need to put yourself in the place of the audience and understand their pain points. Okay. So always write useful content, since the readers would read only if there is something in it for them. Okay. You have to write only for the readers. So remember to write, rewrite and edit. So always write your draft first and then rewrite it, go through it, edit it and rewrite it as long as you are getting satisfied with your own content. So next, the third rule is, always start your sentence with the most important words. Okay, so now we'll see why we need to do that. So first and foremost thing is, you have to avoid modifiers and qualifiers. Why? Because it would make the readers to work hard and understand what you exactly deliver. Okay, so avoid using the words like I think, I know, I guess, likely, possible, probably, etc. So because if you write like I guess, possibly or probably, then you are not sure about what you are going to deliver. Okay, so this will make the reader to get confused. So always start your sentence with subject and verb. So this is very simple so that the people can easily understand. This will be more appealing for the readers. So let's take an example. So this is the first sentence of an introductory paragraph of a Centers for Disease Control and Prevention style guide. Okay, so what they have written, according to the National Assessment of Adult Literacy released in 2006 by the US Department of Education, 30 million adults struggle with the basic reading task. Okay, so here the main idea or the main point which they want to deliver is, 30 million adults struggle with the basic reading task. Okay, so we can put this important point at the start of the sentence. Okay, we can rewrite it like this: 30 million adults struggle with reading according to the National Assessment of Adult Literacy report released in 2006 by the US Department of Education. Okay, so if we put it like this, the reader will not get distracted. So it will eliminate the distraction of the reader. Okay, that is the main purpose why we have to place all the important ideas in the start of the sentence. Okay, so let us take another example. So this is taken from this HubSpot.com. As of 2019, a survey of bloggers found that 32% of respondents always check the analytics of their blog post. So this is a Statista 2020. Okay, so the primary idea is here, idea here is 32% of respondents always check the analytics of their blog post. Okay, this is the main idea. So we can rewrite it as, 32% of respondents always check the analytics of their blog post as per the survey in 2019 on bloggers. Okay, so this way you can rewrite your sentence by putting the most important words at the beginning of the sentence. Okay, so here are some of the phrases to avoid at the start of the sentence. According to the study, there is a, it is essential or it is crucial or it is recommended, advised, etc. And the purpose of this mail, the blog or article, okay, in 2021 or any other year, I believe, I think that, etc. And my personal opinion is that. Okay, so this way you can avoid all these sentences and make your content easily readable by the readers.